Hey boys and girls, I'm Rhino, and today we're talking about carbs. Carbs provide energy for the body and the brain. So to say you're going on a carb-free diet is like saying you're going on a chemical-free diet. Everything is chemicals, people. Everything. Alright, I'm going to break this down into three parts. The body, the brain, the diet. So carbs come in two distinct forms, simple and complex. Simple carbohydrate you know as sugar. It's typically either a monosaccharide, which is glucose on its own or fructose on its own, or a disaccharide, which would be two glucose together making maltose, or glucose and fructose making sucrose, etc. Table sugar is always two glucoses together. When there are only two molecules, very easy to break apart. But that means that you're going to digest it too quickly. And if you remember from the gluten-free lesson, when you digest too quickly, all the glucose goes right into your bloodstream, spikes up your insulin, body goes haywire, and you'll run out of all of your energy, and you won't feel full. Bad, 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 bad. What we want is the complex carbohydrates, because they're not a chain of two or three molecules, they're a chain of thousands, and they take a long time to digest. The great thing is a lot of things like dark leafy greens that have those complex carbohydrates also have fiber. Fiber is something we don't actually digest, but it just assists in the process of our digestion, making sure that we are digesting even more slowly and that everything is exiting the body efficiently. Now, those complex carbohydrates are going to be stored in your muscles as glycogen. The glycogen is your fuel, so that when you exercise, you use that glycogen. If you run out of that carbohydrate energy, then your body goes to protein. You don't want your body using protein for fuel. You want the protein to do what it does, building the muscles. But if you have too much of the carbohydrates in your system, it'll turn into fat, because the storage within your muscles is finite, like a storage unit. So you're just going to run out of space. Now, there is a balance to work out, and it really depends how much you eat versus how much you exercise. Think really about how many calories you're burning throughout your entire day. The average person is eating about 300 grams of carbohydrates. Each gram of carbohydrate is about 4 calories worth of energy, and that is going to turn into 1,200 calories worth of complex carbohydrates for you to burn and have fun with. So start putting your little math hats on, figure that out. Now, the second thing is your brain. The carbohydrates are also responsible for helping the blood flow, hypothalamic region of your brain. Now, glucose affects different parts of your brain differently than fructose, most importantly being the striatum. This is one reason high fructose corn syrup isn't great for you. The striatum in the brain is responsible for appetite. And if it's not being, you know, poked by fructose, because the glucose will send it a signal when the fructose doesn't send it as much of a signal, then your body doesn't know that it's full. Your body doesn't know that it's eating, and you continue to eat more and more and more until finally you feel full, but now you've overeaten and you've been eating fructose, which is that refined sugar, and probably not a lot of nutrient value. Which brings us to number three, diet. If you're like, okay, nutrient value, but fruit has fructose. Yeah, fruit has some fructose, and some fructose, some glucose, some simple carbs are just fine for you, but you want to pair it with a lot of complex carbs. The best ones being fruits, vegetables, whole grains, legumes. They're all fantastic for you. Now, when you go to read a label, complex carbohydrates are the total carbohydrates less the amount of sugar and dietary fiber. In processed foods, dietary fiber has been removed along with certain nutrients and minerals. Without the dietary fiber aiding in the digestive process, you're less likely to be breaking down all of those fatty acids, meaning you're retaining fat and gaining weight. So you should want to avoid processed food and
genetically modified organisms.
Now I know what you're thinking. Ryan, if all carbs are sugars, why aren't potatoes sweet? Well, when you have a complex carbohydrate, the chain is just too big for the receptors on your tongue to recognize sweetness. That's why we like glucose and fructose, because the simple ones can be received by the sweetness center of our tongue. Boom. I hope you learned something about carbs. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and tune in next time. I will be doing a scotch egg, or at least attempting it, because I've never made one, but I really want to. They look kind of fun, and I'm going to figure out an easy and lazy way to do it. Boom.